Hi, I'm Branislav Silas. I'm the founder, co-founder, and CEO of Atomontage Inc. We are a technology developer developing a voxel technology for basically games and other products, basically all industries that work with 3D content. We are at Reboot now, showing some bits of our technology to any interesting party. We're growing pretty fast now, so we're aiming at basically doing some little PR for all kinds of talent around the world who could join us in the coming year or two. We can show you some technology examples if you're interested, and most importantly, we want to show you and tell you something about the big vision we have for volumetric graphics.
Talk about your vision and how it differentiates from what's out there in the ecosystem today.
So currently, most technologies typically work with polygon engines, that's polygon meshes, and basically this kind of technology defines the surface of things, not really the content. We're focusing on volumetric representation, and if we manage to develop a technology that's better than the rest, everybody will basically switch to a volumetric technology and volumetric content. That means that basically any product will be capable to simulate the world very realistically. People will be able to interact with the geometry in a destructive way, so they'll be able to construct things easily, even small children, without any kind of learning necessary, because if they're used to work with volumetric things, volumetric matter in the real world, like everybody's used to it from the childhood already, they'll be able to do the same in the virtual world, because we have virtual matter there. And our technology allows to create worlds that are huge and very detailed. We can compare that stuff with Minecraft, for example, but Minecraft works based on large cubes, while our voxels, which are kind of cubes also, are so tiny you don't really see them. So you're not limited to any kind of particular aesthetics. You can work with realistic content, you can simulate it, you can interact with it, you can play games, or maybe enter into a VR movie, sort of, and almost interact with the actors in such movie. So if we're right, and it seems that we are, in the next couple years, maybe 5 years to a decade, the most developers will switch to volumetric technology, because it allows them to do more stuff far more cheaply than with polygon technologies.
How will that impact, for example, in the game industry, popular technologies like Unreal Engine or Unity?
Well, we believe that everybody will switch to voxels rather sooner than later. It's hard to tell whether they will develop their own technologies, voxel technologies, or something will emerge in their ecosystems. So maybe some third-party developer will provide such solution. We also know that it takes really long to develop such technology. There were many attempts, like 2 dozens of attempts, to create a great voxel engine, but all have failed. So there are some interesting games out there, like Playbook and, of course, Dreams, which are kind of volumetric. And we can expect that more companies will switch to similar technologies soon, but so far we can see it's so hard to develop such technology that likely most technology providers will basically license an existing technology. It could be ours.
Is there anyone using your technology for video game development right now?
Well, we are prototyping one game with, I cannot tell it, but we're in early stage of prototyping a concept based on our technology. So that game will basically leverage all the great potential that can be used in a very simple way, very quickly. So it's a small game. And the other project we have is not really aimed at games, but games can benefit from that technology. It's a technology project. So it can be used anywhere where people use 3D content.